Good morning. Welcome to the 2013-2014 MIC SAD Prom Disaster Presentation. My name is Jenna Christner. I am a member of MIC SAD. Thank you for your time in joining us today.
Hello, I'm Josh Porter, another member of MIC SAD. We would like to emphasize the fact that you are not required to attend this program. If you have no desire to be here, or you choose to be disrespectful and not pay attention, you may leave the auditorium and sit in the office for the remainder of the presentation.
Hi, I'm Jake Schweitzer, treasurer of MIC SAD. We are missing valuable class time for this presentation, so we ask for your full attention throughout the entire presentation. We do not want to waste your time, and we certainly do not want to waste ours.
Hi, I'm Aaron McCullough, secretary of MIC SAD. We ask that you please respect the time and effort put into this presentation. It took many hours to put together, and it was all for your benefit.
Hi, I'm Mikhail Ellison, vice president of MIC SAD. If this presentation can cause one person to make the right decision on prom night and future situations, then the effort, energy, and time put into this was well worth it. Just remember, one bad decision can affect your family and friends forever.
Hi everyone, I'm Gabrielle Kaur, president of MIC SAD. Events like what you're about to see today happen in schools everywhere all the time. The purpose of this presentation is to serve as a warning. So please, give the phones a rest, enjoy the show, but take its meaning seriously. Thank you.
This spring, over 26,000 high schools across the United States will throw proms. Nearly 18 million high school students shall be attending one of those proms. Over 50% of students will consume alcohol after prom.
In Pennsylvania, a legally drunk person has a blood alcohol concentration of at least 0.08. For someone weighing 140 pounds, it only takes roughly 3 drinks to reach this level.
The penalty for first-time DUI offenders in Pennsylvania is $300 fine. Second-time offenders can receive up to a $2,500 fine and 2 months in jail. The third-time offenders may receive up to a $5,000 fine and 2 years in jail.
Every 2 hours, 3 people are killed in alcohol-related crashes, meaning 36 people die every day.
In the recent year, people aged 16 to 24 were involved in 28% of all alcohol-related driving accidents, although they make up only 14% of the U.S. population.
Out of these crashes, on average, 380 students died in alcohol-related crashes on their prom night.
Let's go! The way! Oh, you don't want none! Baby,
where's come on, Aaron? Throw me the puck!
Josh, be quiet! Where's my boy LeBron? Give it to the MVP! Give it to the MVP!
Ah!
Touchdown! Yes! Josh,
that's a basket. Oh. I don't even know what the heck I'm playing.
Come on, John Wall. Bring it on, John Wall!
Alright guys, let's pause this.
Oh, come on! What?
We gotta get serious here.
What?
Who are we taking to prom?
Not Mikhail!
No.
I'll take Gibby.
No.
I wanna take Gibby.
No! I'll just go with Jenna.
What if I wanna go with Jenna?
Alright guys, alright, like, I got a way I can... Alright, we'll figure this out this way. Alright guys, this is what we got. Long straws Gibby. Medium straws Jenna. Short straws Mikhail. I'm gonna put them all together and we're gonna pick, alright? Josh, you get the first pick.
He's got Mikhail.
I'm not going with Mikhail.
Yeah, I'm not going with Mikhail.
Yes!
Who you got?
Oh, I got Jenna, man.
Alright, let's get it. Yeah! You gotta take Mikael! I got Gibby. Woo! How you gonna ask her?
I got an idea.
Rarely take advantage of them offensively. We're gonna turn over. They couldn't get it inbounds that time. It's getting late in the season. Let's now see the standings out east. Taking a look at Miami. Right now.
What does he want? Prom? What the crap does that mean? Huh. Question mark. Do you want to go to prom with me?
You shall not pass without saying yes.
I'll go. Wait, who is this? Oh, hi, Josh. Yes, hey. I'll go with you.
This is so stupid. I'll do it. All right. I'll do it. She's gonna think this is so stupid.
This is your one shot, bro.
Help me out. Tape it off. This is gonna be so dumb. I need bigger tape than that. Alright, we're good. Alright. I like the deal. Oh my gosh. Okay.
Nice. Alright, you ready?
Ring the doorbell.
After prom? I don't know. I mean, whatever you think people would like. Yeah, okay. Just let me know what I need to pay you back. Okay. Thank you. Bye.
Escorted by Aaron Chainsaw McCullough! their smooth moves on the dance floor. Our last couple this evening is Mikkel Ellison, escorted by Jacob K. Swiss Schweitzer. Well, that concludes this year's Grand March. Thank you all for attending and have a terrific day.
Get it?
Go.
Come on, Mikkel.
Oh! Oh! Take a drink, Josh. Oh, Josh, slow down! All
right, wait!
Slow down, man!
I can't help myself,
here, guys.
Just can't do it.
Come on, Jake. Come on!
Get it.
Nah,
swagger not today.
Oh.
Get out of here.
Come on, Josh, put the team on your back, man. Team on your... Oh. This is cool.
I got this. I got this guy.
Get out of here.
Yeah.
Get out of here. Yeah. Let's go, Josh.
We're burning moonlight. Come on. Woo!
Let's go, Jake. Jake, let's go.
Jake.
We'll take a 3 hour to school.
Wait, no one drives.
We're going. Let's go, Jake.
Wait. My book bag.
Come on.
We're burning moonlight.
Woo! Jake, let's go.
Shut up.
Woo!
0 of my alcohol intake equals infinity!
I'm tired of all this Penn State stuff here. Give me that. Give me that. Right here. Hail to Pitt. Woo!
Turn up all the bottles! Yeah. Woo!
Guys, give the leopard some beer!
Yeah. Woo!
You get food?
God bless America!
There you go, Mikael.
Togo!
Are you serious?
What?
You!
Yeah!
Give me your parking pass! Forever!
What happened? Oh my gosh.
Jonah.
What did I do?
Aaron, what the f-
Jake! What happened? Jenna!
Aaron!
Jenna, you're right!
What did you do?
I didn't mean to. You crashed the car! I didn't mean to. I didn't mean for this to happen! I'm just driving!
What were you doing?
I didn't drive!
Jenna, go ahead and talk!
Jenna! You're right!
I got a football game to play in the bus!
I didn't try!
You're an asshole!
I'm sorry! Dude, I didn't mean to do
it! All the time we spent lifting! You ruined it.
I didn't mean to.
Oh my gosh.
Dude, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, Jake.
Aaron.
I didn't mean for this to happen.
How can you crash the car, dude?
Okay. We're at Cedar Creek. My friends are in a wreck. One can't move. One's not even talking. Please hurry. Please hurry.
Jenna, wake up. Jenna's not waking up, Gibby. Someone's coming. Jenna, it's okay. It's okay. Stay with me. Come on, wake up. Wake up, Jenna. Wake up, Jenna. Come on. Aaron, what'd you do?
Relax a minute.
I didn't mean for any of this to happen.
Just come over here.
I'm sorry.
Sit down right there.
Is he hurt too?
I can't feel my leg.
What happened to you? Okay, all right. Hang on one second. We're going to get you out. Can you get out on your own?
No.
You can. All right, hang on. We're going to get you out. Is your door able to open up? Hold on. Relax.
Jake, I'm sorry.
What's up?
You
can't feel your legs. Do you have a seatbelt on?
No.
You didn't? Okay.
What'd you do?
I didn't mean for this to happen.
What'd you do?
I didn't try. I just lost control.
Okay.
Am I going to be able to walk?
Well, we're going to find out, bud. Just relax a minute, okay? We got help here. We got to attend to what's going on in the back seat first.
Okay.
All right? Just relax. Right. Don't move around a lot, all right? Just
sit there. Another truck coming, Gary.
Okay. Just sit there. Try not to move a lot, okay? Because I don't want to make a bad injury worse.
Let me get a call right quick.
Let me get a call on you, bud, okay? Just make sure there's nothing wrong with your neck or anything. Anything else hurting you besides your legs?
I can't feel.
You can't feel? Okay. Alright,
bud. I'm sorry. You're sorry for what? What did you do?
I lost control.
Okay. Stand right here. How many did you have to drink?
I just had a couple bottles. Not that much.
A couple bottles of what?
There was some coconut rum that I had a little bit of, and there was a couple bottles of Michelob, and I don't know. I'm sorry.
You drank a few what?
You drank a few bottles? Of Michelob and then a couple shots of coconut rum.
Okay. So where did this happen at?
My house.
Where do you live at?
5 Little Lynch Drive.
Alright, listen to me very carefully, alright? There's a lot of stuff going on there. I don't need you to be concerned with it. I need you to pay attention to me.
Okay.
It's very important that you pay attention and do what I tell you, alright? I'm going to give you a field sobriety test to see your ability to have driven that vehicle. Okay, so I'm going to explain and demonstrate 2 tests. I don't want you to start these tests until I specifically tell you to start. But I want you to listen to me all the way through, ask you if you have questions. If you do, you can address them at that time, okay?
Yes, sir.
Do you have any physical disabilities?
No, sir.
Are you on any medications?
No.
All right. First test I'm going to have you do is called a one-leg raise. You're going to stand with your head straight up, your arms to your side. You're going to keep your knee locked in place. You can choose your left or your right leg. I don't care whichever. Lift it off the ground. You can watch my leg this time.
Okay.
About 6 inches off the ground. I want you to count 1-1000, 2-1000, 3-1000, 4-1000, 5-1000, 6-1000. Until I tell you to stop, okay?
Okay.
Do you have any questions about that test?
No, sir.
You ready to start it?
Yes.
Go ahead, start it.
1-1000, 2-1000, 3-1000. 4-1000, 5-1000, 6-1000.
And what did you see?
We were driving alongside them.
It just went. Like we were with them, and then they just took off, and then
they passed you. They passed you guys. Did you see the accident? You just came across it, you see what you saw. Were you going fast? Were you guys going fast too? No.
7-1000. 8-1000.
Okay, the next test is called a hill-to-toe walk, okay? What I'm going to have you do is, you can imagine a line on the ground. It doesn't have to be a line. You're going to look straight forward, keeping your hands to your side, your head straight up. You're going to touch your heel to your toe, just like I have right here, okay?
Just watch me.
You're going to count out loud. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. You're going to take small pivoting steps, and you're going to walk 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 back.
Okay.
Do you have any questions about that test?
No, sir.
None at all?
No.
Go ahead, begin that test.
Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13.
Up. Ready up?
Jenna. Is she gonna be okay?
She's pretty critical, Gary. Let's just get going, okay?
Yep. Ready?
Yeah.
Put your hand in the back of the truck.
Why?
Take your legs out. Take them out. You got any weapons on you?
No, sir.
What do you have on you?
A cell phone. I didn't mean for any of this to happen.
It happened, didn't it?
Are my friends going to be okay?
Fine enough, my man. Put your hand down the back.
Oh my God, I can't believe this is happening.
What's my mom going to
arrest him for?
She's probably my
driving
home.
Under the influence of alcohol or controlled substances, which means drugs or alcohol. Come on, back off the car.
Where am I going?
I'm in the back of the car.
I can't believe this is happening.
Come see.
Put your butt in first. Watch your head. Slide in. Just relax. We're going to go to our station. We'll talk about it further, okay? Yeah.
Okay.
Patient's paralyzed from the waist down. We'll need a rim.
Sir, just give us a minute here. We're going to lift you over.
Am I going to be okay?
They're going to take good care of you here.
He was the understrained front seat passenger, high speed collision into a tree head on. A lot of damage done to the vehicle. Patient initially awake and oriented, knew what was going on, unable to feel anything from the waist down, unable to move his legs, got a lot of numbness and tingling. He's got good movement up in the top and everything like that. He said he was drinking a lot this evening. So other than that, we mobilized him like we usually do and got him moving pretty quick up here to you guys.
Alright. Jake, I'm Dr. Walther, honey. What hurts right now?
My back.
Okay. Any pain in your chest?
A little.
Anything in your belly?
Not really.
Okay, I want you to hold real still for me, okay? I'm going to check a couple of things. Can you feel me now? Just poke you. And just, can you feel that up here?
Yeah.
Okay, how about down here?
Yeah.
All right. Give me a good squeeze. Okay. How about, can you feel this?
Yes.
Can you feel this?
Yes.
Okay, give me a good squeeze. Okay, lift your arms up for me. Okay. Let me just undo. I don't want you to move anything. Can you feel this?
No.
At all?
Uh-uh.
Can you feel this?
No.
How about up here? Can you feel?
Yeah.
How about any lower than that? Can you feel?
Mm-mm. No.
Nothing?
Uh-uh.
Okay, wiggle your toes for me. Wiggle this one.
I'm trying.
Are you able to lift your legs?
No.
Okay. I'm just going to check one other thing here. Just checking your reflexes.
He didn't have any movement for us either.
All right, wait, hold still. I need a stat CT of the cervical, thoracic, and lumbar spine. Let's do a quick blood draw here. grab me a 2x2 out of the drawer. Were you drinking tonight, Jake?
Yes.
Any drugs?
No.
All right, you're going to feel a pinch here, okay?
Okay.
Okay, Matt, could you send this off for a stat alcohol level and drug screen, please?
Absolutely, doctor.
All right, I want you to not move. I'm going to get you something for pain. We're going to go over and get a CT scan of your entire spine. We're concerned you have a spinal cord injury, and we need to work quickly.
Okay.
Okay.
Jenna's okay. She's badly, badly hurt. But she's gonna be fine, right?
Probably not. It doesn't look good. She's not responsive. And I took her away.
How long am I have to stay in here?
Until we're done. We have charges to type, fingerprints to obtain. Alright. You have a belt on?
Yes, sir.
Jewelry or anything?
Just a belt.
I need your belt and your tennis shoes. Take them off. Kick them off.
Here you go.
I'm going to check you down one more time before I shut the door to make sure I didn't miss anything. Turn around, put your hands on the wall.
Okay.
So make sure I didn't leave anything on you that you could harm yourself with.
Have a seat. So this is it?
You're gonna hang out there, we're gonna fingerprint photograph you. Your charges are gonna be prepared, and you're gonna go in front of Magistrate Christner so you know where you're going for tonight.
But I didn't mean for any of this to happen, so I'm just stuck in here now.
Yeah.
After a stupid decision. I'm so stupid.
Sit down. Shut up. Stop. It already happened. What's done is done. There's nothing you can do about it. Just sit there and be quiet. You understand?
I'll get back with you in a minute. I'm stuck here. So.
God. Okay, I guess you guys are the one that called.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Did you guys, what did you see when you arrived on the scene?
We were driving and they just took off.
They took off from you.
And then we just rode down the road and then they wrecked into a tree and Jenna wanted to get up and then Jake wanted to get out of the car. He couldn't feel his legs and then it was terrible. Are they going to be okay? Officer, please say they're going to be okay.
Jenna's not in very good condition.
What?
Jenna's not in good condition. And Aaron's in a lot of trouble right now.
What's wrong with Aaron? Where's he at?
He's back there. He's in a lot of trouble right now.
Is he going to jail, Jake?
There's a good chance he is, yes.
Oh my gosh.
Jake, okay.
What's wrong with Jake?
He's alright. He's got injuries as well, but his aren't as bad as Jenna's.
What's wrong with Jenna?
She's injured bad. Very
bad. Is she
bad.
Talking? Is she?
She's not.
Oh my God.
Alright, listen.
Get in trouble.
Well, we'll get to that. I'm going to have another officer come in and talk to you guys, get further information about exactly what happened, and we'll go from there. Okay? Just remain calm. Calm down. We got some things we have to do, and then we'll go from there, okay? Alright.
Thank you. Jake, it's Dr. Walther again.
No.
We have some bad news.
What?
We have two fractures, one in your cervical spine and one in your lower back. And one has transected or cut the spinal cord that is going to be leaving you paralyzed from the waist down. I'm sorry.
You can't put me in a cast and I can
recover?
A spinal cord injury is not something that's surgically repairable. We cannot. We're going to be sending you down to the trauma center, which they can stabilize the bones to prevent a second injury. We're fortunate enough that this injury is low enough. It's not, you still have use of your upper arms. You're still able to breathe, but you will never play football again.
How? How can it be true?
You will never walk again.
That can't be right.
I know this is shocking, and this is
life. I gotta play football. I've been working my whole life to play in college.
I understand that, but your college days are still going to happen. It's just going to be without football. You're most likely going to be in a wheelchair the rest of your life.
That can't be true.
I know this is shocking. We need to work quickly here. Our job is to keep you kind of immobilized till we can get you down to the trauma center so the neurosurgeon can stabilize these fractures to prevent any further injury. Are your parents here?
I think they're on their way. How am I supposed to tell them?
Would you like me to help tell them?
Yeah. What am I supposed to tell the coaches at Georgetown?
I don't know. Let's worry about just getting you taken care of medically first. You can worry about talking to your coach and your friends later.
Down. Right here. Don't move. You understand?
Yes, sir.
This isn't playtime anymore. Some real stuff happened out there. You made some real decisions. This isn't playtime. This is our house. You don't move until you're told to move. You understand?
Yes, sir.
I can't believe I did this.
What's my family gonna think?
Well, you just ruined your life. That's a decision you made.
I've never drank it before in my life. And everyone always said I wasn't cool. I just wanted to try it for once.
What happened?
Ended bad.
What happened?
I'm so stupid.
It only takes once. There's a young girl out there fighting for her life and it doesn't look good. Guess what that's gonna mean for you? A lot of problems with us. Once, twice, 30 times, it doesn't matter. You did it right today. You're a good friend of yours.
I just thought we were having a fun time. And Jake, he's my best friend. We've been lifting together since 7th grade. Now if he's hurt, it's all ruined.
It's already done. You know the saying that it is what it is?
Yes.
Well, it's done. There's no fixing it. There's no going back. Whatever you decided to do to get you out there, to put you into that tree, to put her in the ambulance, it's done. There's no change to it.
I wish I could change my decision.
You don't have to wish. Spell your last name.
MCCULLOUGH.
First name.
Aaron.
Middle name.
Patrick.
Social Security number.
172-53-3841.
Birth date.
November 3rd, 1995. Do you know where my friends are?
They all been taken for treatment at the hospital. I have no idea how they are.
Oh, gosh.
They're not good. None of it's good.
I hope they're alright.
Alright, stay with the program here.
Okay.
Where were you born at? What state?
Pennsylvania.
Do you have any nicknames you go by?
Saw.
Saw?
Yes.
Spell
my nickname since second grade. S-A-W.
Just S-A-W, alright. Alright. I'm gonna ask you some questions for the processing procedure. What's your height?
5'11".
Weight?
200 pounds. What's all this for?
This is part of the processing procedure. It's done to everybody who's under arrest, which you are. Alright, listen, I'm going to get you up. I'm going to uncuff you. Don't do anything stupid. Stand up. Turn around. You only do what you're told to. Anything else is going to result in some problems with me. You understand?
Yes, sir.
Don't be stupid. Just listen to what I have to say and we'll get through it. It's already bad enough as it is.
I didn't mean for any of this to happen.
Be that as it may, it already happened. Alright. Stand over to that side of the gray background. Turn around and face forward. There's a camera there, I'm sure you can see.
Yes.
Do not smile.
Look straight forward at the camera. Hold still. Stand straight up.
Is that my mugshot?
Yes, what it is.
Do you realize what you did tonight? Do you have any idea? You're still intoxicated. You're not even going to know what's going on until tomorrow. I mean, even though you think you know right now, you have no idea.
I'm sorry.
Sorry doesn't do anything. Sorry does nothing. It doesn't take you home. It doesn't make everything better. It doesn't mean anything. It's done. It's not going back. And tomorrow, let me assure you, when you wake up, it's going to be 10 times worse.
I wish I could change everything.
Well, there's no genie here that's going to help you out. Understand?
Yes, sir.
It's done. You're going to get a copy of the charges and be able to review them before you go in front of Magistrate Christner.
Okay. What about college?
You can push that out of your mind for now.
But I'm already accepted to Pitt. I sent in my deposit money.
Not much of that's going to matter. I don't think, see, you're not understanding. You understand more tomorrow. Right now, you're not understanding.
But I've had my whole future ahead of me. I was going to go to medical school. I wanted to save lives, not ruin them.
You made a big boy decision tonight. You made a big boy decision to drink. Now this is a big boy circumstance of that decision, you understand? This is the real world. This is what happens.
Sir.
Doesn't matter what plans you have. All that you can scratch for now.
KTI 732, Mon Valley Hospital, Rush Driver, Medic 7.
It's Mon Valley, go ahead, Medic 7.
We're currently 8 to 10 minutes away from your facility with a, we're estimating 17 to 18 year old female patient involved in an MVA. Patient is currently unresponsive. We do have her intubated. Her last blood pressure was 40 over pelvic. Patient was unrestrained in the back seat of a vehicle. She's been unresponsive the whole time for us. She's as well as her respiratory status has been unstable as well. Other questions, we'll see you in 10.
Small Valley Hospital, see you in 10. We'll need a room 1 for this patient, unresponsive MVA, possible trauma arrest.
There was heavy damage to the vehicle. She's been unresponsive the whole time. The highest her blood pressure's been has been 40 over pelf at best. No meds or medical history that we know of. She, like I said, her respiratory status has also been bad the whole time with no improvement with any intervention.
All right, let's prepare to intubate. Leanne, Dr. Bradley is 7-2 in a moment to coat, please. Do we have any pulses right now?
She's 49 on the monitor right now.
Hold compressions, please, for a second. All right. All right, let's prepare for intubation.
She's still holding in a sinus braid.
Okay. IV fluids running wide, please. All right. Alright, let's take a listen. What is our pressure right now, Leanne?
113 over 74.
Ask the lab, please, for 4 units of fresh frozen plasma and 4 units of... Blood. I need an amphibathy, please. We're losing pulses. I have no pulses now. No pulse. She's gradiating down.
Gradiating down. Doc, she's asystole.
All right, I need an epi, please. Continued compressions. Still pulseless. Still asystole on the monitor. Continued compressions, please. How many other victims were there?
Just one other one.
Still asystole on the monitor.
Still asystole.
Continue compressions. IV fluids wide. You may start the blood. What do we have on the monitor?
She's still asystole.
Asystole. Another amp of epi, please.
Second epi in.
Still equal breath sounds.
Blood still flowing.
Bleeding controlled on all the head wounds. What do we have on the monitor?
Still asystole.
What do we got, Leanne?
We're still asystole.
I'm sorry. I think we lost her. Let's take a... Pupils are fixed and dilated. Do we have any respiratory effort?
None at all.
No heartbeat, no respiratory effort. Thank you. Are you guys with Jake and Jenna?
Yes.
I'm Dr. Walther.
Let me grab it.
Just gonna pull up a chair here.
Are they gonna be okay?
Is
Jenna alright?
Let's just start. I'm gonna tell you about Jake first. Okay. First of all, were any of you three injured? I have some bad news about Jake. He has a serious spinal cord injury. He's completely paralyzed from the waist down. Fortunately, he still has movement from the waist up. He's still able to move his arms and breathe. Some aren't so lucky. He, however, is going to be left in a wheelchair for the rest of his life. We have him, we'll let you come back and see him briefly, but we're transporting him via helicopter down to the trauma center. We're hoping these injuries in his back can be stabilized to prevent any more damage, but the damage that's been done is permanent. He'll be permanently paralyzed from the waist down. I'm sorry, I know that's devastating news.
Can you please talk to him, please?
Yeah, we need just a few minutes to get him ready for the helicopter. Is Jenna also with you guys?
Yeah, is she all right? Can we talk to her, please?
No, I have devastating news about Jenna. Jenna has died. Jenna had significant injuries, internal injuries, and significant head trauma. Initially had a weak pulse when she came in, but we lost her. Despite doing everything for her, she died of massive head injuries and massive internal injuries.
Please.
I'm very sorry.
There's nothing else you can do?
There's nothing. Jenna's gone.
Oh my God.
Jenna's gone. I'm very sorry. I wish there was more we could do, but the injuries were just too expensive.
Does her parents know?
Not yet. They're on their way.
Oh my gosh.
I'm gonna go back and finish taking care of Jake, and we'll have you come back when we can.
All right. What's this?
This is your fingerprints. All right. It's imperative that you don't push, you don't roll your own fingers, you don't push down. So let me do the pushing and rolling and everything else. This is just water, okay?
Yes, sir. What's all this for?
This is part of the process when you get arrested for drinking and driving and homicide by vehicle. When these things come up, this is what we have to do. You need your fingerprints, your photograph, One copy goes with us, one copy goes to state police, and one copy goes to the FBI.
So now I have a record forever.
Absolutely. Where are your parents at? You have any idea?
I have no idea.
They're not allowed in here.
Do you know when I can see them?
Let me tell you, you can.
How soon
will I be? Don't worry about seeing them. There's not much they can do for you except hire an attorney. It's about all they can do for you right now. That and visit you at Westmoreland County Jail.
I don't want to make them pay for an attorney.
If you want them to do something, that's about all they can do for you right now. They didn't drink the alcohol. They didn't load everybody up in their car. They didn't drive drunk and crash into a tree and kill one of their friends. This is the real world out here. Doesn't matter if you did it once, 10 times, doesn't matter. The outcome is the same outcome. This is what we tell you guys in school.
Five years of incarceration in a state penal institution. Understand that?
Yes, sir.
This is pretty serious stuff, right?
Yes.
Right. You ever been treated for a drug addiction or an alcohol addiction?
No, sir.
Right. If I'm to believe that the complaint is correct, you used alcohol. You have used alcohol in the past, right?
This is my first time.
First time you've ever consumed?
Yes, sir.
That looks like I'm stupid.
No.
Call. You choose prom night, you thought great.
I thought it would be a fun time.
Yeah.
Senior year.
First time ever tried?
Yes.
Right. Ever been treated for any type of mental illness?
No, sir.
Any thoughts of suicide?
No.
None?
No, sir.
Right. I'm going to take you back just a little bit. We have met. I believe I met you at the National Honor Society when you inducted new members.
Yes, sir.
And I remember that you were the president of the National Honor Society.
Yes.
So, one would think that your intelligence level was high. One would think that the future was bright for Mr. McCullough. Would they not?
Yes. Just one stupid decision.
What's that?
One stupid decision. I guess I just wasn't thinking.
Yeah. You know, and I seen on that video the police officer indicated to you, we can't go back there. We can't change it.
Wish I could.
Could, yeah. But would it be reasonable for me to believe that you had plans for the future?
Yes, I was going to go to Pitt and maybe attend medical school one day.
Medical school?
Yes, sir.
I guess one bad choice has derailed that train. You think?
Is there any way I can still get it?
I don't know if that's going to be up to me.
But I worked so hard my whole life.
Really?
Getting to a good college. I wanted to save lives. Being a doctor. Not ruining them.
But didn't you have fun that evening? Wasn't that alcohol and the festive atmosphere? Wasn't that fun, Mr. McCullough?
No, sir. Not after what happened.
Thought it was at the time.
I thought it was.
Right. You have the right to secure an attorney of your choice. If you can't afford to hire an attorney, what would be appointed to represent you in your choice? Do you have an attorney?
No, sir.
You have an attorney in mind?
I don't think so.
Good. Do you want to apply for a public defender?
I'd rather do that than making my family pay for an attorney.
Does your family have the wherewithal to pay for the attorney?
I'm sure they do, but I don't want to make my family do that for me.
Have you had a conversation with your family at any point?
I haven't seen my family since the crash.
All right. After this proceeding, you'll be afforded a phone call. I'll give you two phone calls. I'll give you a phone call to your parents, and I'll give you a phone call to a bondsman if it's deemed. If it's deemed, that's the way you want to go. So you want me to fill out the paperwork for a public defender?
I think so.
Alright, you're entitled to a preliminary hearing. Now, at the preliminary hearing, what transpires is you have a hearing where in front of me where testimony would be given, and what the Commonwealth would have to prove is that the charges that you're facing go beyond a reasonable doubt and would be held for the next term of court. If they couldn't prove that, then I'd have to toss the charge. Understand? But if, you know, what I'm reading in here, your blood alcohol, well, did you do a BAC?
Yes, sir.
Well,
I don't
think it is.
0.25.
0.25? Yeah, that's...
Uh-huh.
Three times the legal limit. And anyhow, you're entitled to a preliminary hearing. Did I give you a date?
No, sir.
It's going to be May the 24th in my eye. All right, I'm at that junction in the arraignment process, whereas I'm going to give you an opportunity to address the court about your wrong, and I'll also give the officer an opportunity to address it. Would you like to go first?
I don't know what to say, sir. My friend's dead, my best friend since second grade's in a wheelchair. I'm scared.
Here it is. Your freedom is in my hands. One stroke of the pen, you're in jail. You have nothing to say.
I don't know.
This is the most pivotal point of that 18 years of your life. You understand that?
I ruined two lives, though. Why should I be set free?
Oh, you don't want to be set free. I can handle that. Is that what you're telling me?
I think so.
You are? But you want to go to jail?
I don't want to go to jail, but...
What are you saying?
After what I did, I feel I should.
What's that?
After what I did, I feel I should.
Well, good. We can handle that, right?
Yes.
How much more do you want? You want to go to jail, but you don't know how much more you want.
I don't know what I want right now.
$20 million?
I'm just confused. I never thought this would happen to me.
You want to go to jail, McCullough, or not?
I don't.
No, now you don't want to go to jail.
I don't want to go to jail. I never planned on going to jail ever in my life. But I can't believe what I did last night.
Commonwealth, let me know. Go ahead, Mike.
Yes, Judge, it's Commonwealth's position that although the defendant is in high school and probably his first offense was a rather egregious one, our position is that he have a high bond, being a flight risk because of the homicide. That's a serious charge, and regardless of whether this is his first time or not, that he needs to be held accountable.
All right, Mr. McCullough, we're at the end of the arraignment process. Before I set your bond, do you have any questions pertaining to what's transpired?
No, sir.
All right, I'm going to set your bond at $500,000. You'll be afforded the opportunity to post bond. Now, recognize that you don't have to post $500,000. It can be property. It must be the equivalent of $500,000. It can be a bondsman. A bondsman will charge you 7%. How's your math?
It's okay.
How much is it?
I'm not too sure, sir.
$35,000. Anyhow.
How's my family supposed to pay $35,000? That's a lot of money.
Yeah, absolutely. My job is to assure your appearance at trial and take the appropriate actions to protect the citizens of the Commonwealth. I think that's an appropriate one.
Okay.
All right. I order that the defendant be taken forthwith to the Westmoreland County Detention Center. Taken into custody. All right, I don't think I'll get an opportunity to address you at a later point. But recognize, if this were actual, one bad choice, one bad decision, you know, and I couldn't help but watch. You know, the highlights and the laughter and the parts that you guys most enjoyed? You most enjoyed was the frolicking and the consumption parts of it where it looked like the kids were having one heck of a good time. I mean, that's when you laughed and you enjoyed it and everything like that. Okay, that's good, that's cool. I chuckled myself at some point. But you gotta recognize where it may lead. A bad decision can lead to bad things in the future. Now, if this were true, Aaron McCullough and Jake Schweitzer, they had it going on. I mean, their life looked rosy, peachy. The future was bright. Jenna Kressner, future was bright. All these kids and the other three, the memories that will remain with them for the rest of their life, all because of a bad choice. Now recognize, May 16, we're going to the prom. May 16, what else are we going to do? There's always the party after the prom. We take off the tuxedos and the fancy dresses and we head out to have a little bit of fun. Now, what do I recognize? I recognize there's going to be alcohol used by some of you. That plan's already in process. We've heard. The word's out. Going to be some alcohol parties. My God, think about it a little bit. It can end up badly. Is it necessary? Is that the only way we as humans can have fun? By putting stimulants in our body? I don't think so. It doesn't have to be that way. Now, as a member of the Belle Vernon community, I want you folks to have the greatest prom ever. I want you to have memories that are everlasting. And I don't want to see a headline where some type of tragedy came to us. There's a lot of work that is put into these programs. It's done for a reason. The Mugshot kids, the Mugshot people, I commend you. It's one heck of a job you do every year. That was a great piece of work. The Vicki McCullough, she puts forth the energy on a continuous basis for you kids, for our community. Have a great 2014 prom.
Hello? Coach Miller. Not too good. I have some bad news to tell you.
Let me hear it.
You know how our prom was this past week, and I kind of made the bad decision. I got into a car with a drunk driver with a couple of my friends, and we ended up actually crashing into a tree, and now I'm paralyzed from the waist down. But can I still come to Georgetown to get my degree? I can help out with the football team in any way.
I'm sorry, Jake, but we can't do that. We can't admit students to have their second tell them more.
But like I thought I was already accepted, so I thought I could just come anyway. But I've worked so hard my whole life for this. Are you sure? There's nothing you can do? Okay, Coach. Thanks for giving me the opportunity. Thanks.
just make you get in the car with me. I remember when you first got back to school after being sick, it's fourth or fifth grade. You didn't deserve this. I'm sorry. So many years. You fought so hard. You fought so hard to live. And one stupid decision. I'm so sorry. I love you.
Fun at prom. You were the best prom date a guy could ask for. And then one stupid decision leaves you like this. You had such a bright future, Jenna. Now it's just all thrown away. I don't know why we made these stupid choices. We all knew better.
Jenna, I'm so sorry this had to happen to you. I made the wrong choice. I shouldn't have ever let me or you both get in the car with Aaron. We knew that he couldn't drive properly. I feel like this is all my fault. Your parents probably want to kill me. You fought so hard your whole life, and now it's ruined because of a stupid choice that we made.